80th birthday, 50th wedding anniversary, and preparing for another season of festivals and performances. As Britain's long-standing king and queen of jazz, perhaps you'll be able to fill us in on the secret of successfully living and working with the same man, her husband, John Dankworth. But he's not the only fella she's performed with.
Take that ride again. So starry-eyed again, I'm taking a new play on love. Things are mending now. I see a rainbow blending now. We have a happy ending now. Taking a chance on love.
Take you back.
It does. I don't think I can do that high note anymore.
Oh, it's very impressive.
Oh, it was, wasn't it? Yeah. I impressed myself.
Have you noticed changes in your voices over the years?
Well, the top has gone. That high note, that's right. Definitely gone. But I only acquired it to be noticed.
Really?
Oh yeah. It was. It's not my natural. The naturalness is down here. Uh-huh.
Right.
I'm a baritone, really. Contralto. And
because our Jane's a singer.
I know.
Oh dear. Oh, I'm well impressed.
Oh, she's I know my competition, you know.
But the scat, you're so well known for the scats as well, you know.
I don't know why, because I didn't do too much of it. I'll tell you how it all came about. I was with John Dankworth's big band. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you a little bit more about that. With his big band, and he announced to his singers at the time that it wasn't going to be a singer's band, ever. It would always be a musician's band. So I said, thought about it and said, I'm leaving. I'm not going to... Have... So he said, when I told him that, he said, will you marry me?
Oh, good tactic, yeah.
Very good, very good. So we got married and I left anyway.
Oh, feisty.
You're so,
I know what I was doing.
How did you cope with that, though, working with your husband all the time? Because you've been together
for 50 years. We managed it very well, somehow or other.
Have you ever fallen out, professionally?
Not professionally, really. I mean, we've had our punch-ups, verbal punch-ups, which after 50 years, you can't say that you've never had a punch-up.
No, obviously not.
No. But people say, how can you stand being married to somebody for 50 years? And I thought, well, I think if you'd have been a bricklayer, I wouldn't have done.
Yeah. No. It's quite
respect,
compatible,
isn't
yeah.
It?
He's an amazing... I mean, he's a genius as a musician. Mm-hmm. So to be, if you're married to a genius, you don't argue too much. You know.
You made a huge, huge impression on me. I don't know if you remember when Wing Airport.
Oh.
There was a campaign to have an airport in Buckinghamshire, and my dad's farm was on runway number 3. And we came to isn't it? Your big. You sang in that big equestrian centre, and it was the most fantastic thing. It was the first time I went to a place where there were lots and lots of people, and you just took them in the palm of your hand.
Aww.
So it was worth having the threat of an airport just to have
this fabulous
concert.
We
stopped the airport.
You bloody did,
This is absolutely amazing. I've been sort of reading it, and I can't wait to listen to it. I Hear Music, Cleo Lane and John Dankworth, a celebration of their life and work. How on earth...
From 1951.
Yeah, it's a wonderful photo.
But 49
fantastic
for John.
Photos. How did you go about those selecting what to put in there? Was it a big argumentative process?
It was, yeah. But John was so involved. He has sort of... I've got to do that tomorrow, this now, this in tonight. About... 10 things going on all at the same time, and this was one of them. And they put all the songs and photos and everything in front of us, and he said, "Oh, you do it." So it's basically me.
It was you, wasn't it, making all the shouts.
Typical bloke.
Absolutely.
Can't concentrate.
Well, I don't know about that. Can't concentrate. He can concentrate for each thing and then forgets where he put his glasses.
Mm. So when you first met him, did you know straight away that he was
your soulmate? No. We were talking about soulmates.
Yeah.
I was actually married at the time.
Oh, so were you?
He's
and you met him at an
second
audition?
Husband. I auditioned for him.
Yeah.
Not on the couch.
No, I didn't suggest that at all.
With your voice, you didn't need to, my dear. No.
Well, I don't know. My hobby at that time was auditioning in bands, for bands, you know, to get into the business.
Right.
And I never got anywhere at all until I auditioned for him.
And thank goodness you did, because you're still touring. You've still got dates coming up this year.
And he's writing things for me. Where are we now?
Is it Cheltenham?
On the 5th of May.
Wow.
We're finishing the festival there.
Tottenham Court Palace, is it?
Where? You know
something
what?
Palace.
I know nothing about
Hampton Court. Hampton Court Palace, that's it.
Hampton Court with the... Curtis Steiger.
Nice. Oh, fantastic.
Wow. No, he's lovely.
Yeah, yeah.
He's an American jazzer and wonderful. Yeah.
Did he have a show?
Yeah. I like nice voice. My daughter is a great singer, and I thought, isn't it wonderful she's a great singer? She'd have been an awful singer. I don't know.
A bit embarrassing, really, wouldn't it?
I could have given her back.
How would I have survived it?
Listen, many, many congratulations on the birthday, on the anniversary, and on the retrospective. Best of luck with the concerts. Not that you'll need it. I think you're on a roll now with the career. I think it's working out for you.
Yeah.
I think you're doing okay.
My ambitious moments have come to fruition.
I think you've done okay. Dame Cleo Lane, everybody. That's it from us for now. But tomorrow, Comedy God.